Hey everyone, welcome to Index3D. In today's tutorial, we are going to create an explode view animation of a switch. You can download the 3D model for free from Gumroad, link provided in the description below. So make sure to get that so you can follow along the tutorial. So let's get blending. All the shortcuts I mentioned will be visible in the bottom right corner for your convenience. First, let's add an empty object to help us control entire switch. Press Shift A, choose empty and then sphere. Select all parts of the switch model. Press Ctrl plus P and choose object keep transform. This will parent everything to the empty, allowing us to add secondary motion to the overall animation. Let's rename the empty to switch for better organization. Now let's focus on the stem of our switch. Select it, press K to add a keyframe for its location. If you are using an older version of Blender, you might need to press I instead of K. Move forward on the timeline, adjust the stem's position downward and add another keyframe. This will create basic button press animation, but we need to make it smoother and more dynamic. Next, let's duplicate this keyframe to create a repetitive button press. Select all the keyframes, copy them with a Ctrl C and paste them further along the timeline with a Ctrl plus V. Now we have button press animation, but it's very slow. To speed it up, switch to graph editor by pressing Ctrl plus Tab. Change the pivot point to 2D cursor and scale down the keyframe to speed up the animation. Make sure the playhead is on the first frame before scaling. To keep things clean, delete keyframes on X and Y axis, since we are only animating the Z axis. Next, set the pivot point to individual centers. Select all the top keyframes, scale them, and fine-tune the handles to create more realistic motion. Now let's add some secondary motion to the animation by animating the empty object. Select the empty and add a keyframe by pressing K and choose location. Move the playhead further, move the empty down and add another keyframe. Delete the keyframe on the X and Y axis here as well. Copy and paste this keyframe to create a repetitive motion that complements the stamp animation, adding more life to overall animation. Next, select the housing base, press Shift plus S cursor to selection. Select everything except the housing base and the empty. Move the playhead to the last frame in the timeline. Open the transform panel from the top right corner and click on location. This will help us create explosion animation by scaling the object. Set the pivot point to 3D cursor. Add keyframe to the location of the selected objects. Move forward in the timeline and scale the object in the Z axis. This will move the object with a bit of offset. Press K to add keyframe. Select the last keyframe and move it along the Y axis to fine tune the offset. Select the last two keyframes of all the animated objects. Press T to change the interpolation to cubic. And press Ctrl plus E to change the keyframe easing type to ease out. To create a seamless loop, move all the objects back to their initial location by copying the initial keyframe and pasting them at the end of the animation. Spend more time fine-tuning the curves and adjusting the timing and speed to make the animation more appealing. Let's add a laser effect for the key switch. Select the housing base, press Shift plus S and choose cursor to selection and add a cylinder. Go into the edit mode and scale it down until it's narrow like a laser. Select the bottom face and move it down in the Z axis. In the object properties menu, add a shape key by pressing the plus icon twice. Select the top face of the cylinder, move it up in the Z axis and animate the shape key value to create laser effect. Rename the cylinder to laser and parent it to the empty by dragging it over the empty in the outliner while holding down the shift key. Animate the laser by setting up the keyframe on the shape key value. Match the animation with the stamp motion. add a keyframe to the viewport display icon by right-clicking and inserting a keyframe. In the graph editor, add a noise modifier to the animation channel. Increase the strength and scale of the noise for a glitchy blinking light effect. Restrict the frame range to where the explosion animation happens for the more polished look. Now let's add a camera and animate it. Move the camera along the y-axis, reset the x and z location to 0, and parent the camera to an empty. Animate the camera's location to capture all the objects in the frame. Add a zoom effect by animating the scale of empty. Clean up any unwanted animation channels and fine-tune the F-curves for smooth motion. To enhance the overall animation, let's rotate the switch by adding a 360-degree animation in the Z-axis. Make sure to set the frame interpolation to linear for continuous spin. A quick plug for my Patreon, where I share exclusive content and project files. It's a great way to support my channel. Now let's move to look tab. I won't go step by step through the rendering process, but I'll give you a quick breakdown of the setup. For a material, I have added a bevel to every shader. To create a fake bevel, which is a quick way to add bevels to CAD models in Blender. For plastic material, I'm using noise texture plugged into bump and normal with a roughness of 0.5. The stamp and the bottom housing shares the same material but use different color via object info node and a viewport display color. For a spring, a chrome material with a metallic set to 1 works perfectly. For brushed chrome, using a stretch noise texture in both normal and roughness with a metallic set to 1. The glass material is a mix of glass VHDF and transparent VHDF with the light path nodes shadow ray as a factor. For a purple tint, I have used a volume shader. The laser shader uses a noise texture multiplied by 30 plugged into the material output. For a lighting, I have used area and mesh light to highlight the glass and create a rim around the switch. The fill light is an HDRI from HDRI Heaven set to a strength of 0.25. For the background, I am using a huge plane with a dark gray material. To make the background more interesting, I am using spotlight with a noise texture to create a light gobo. And we can adjust the radius to create a soft light. I am using cycles for rendering with the increased light bounces for glossiness, transmission, and volume to achieve a realistic glass effect. Color management is set to filmic with a very high contrast look and exposure at -0.5. The output settings are 1080p at 24fps, rendering in PNG sequence. Finally, click render and select render animation. Don't forget to check out my recommended playlist and video in the end screen. If you enjoyed this tutorial, consider subscribing, commenting on what you want to learn next. Peace.